When you run into something, do you ever wonder why you would stop? Also, if you need to lift something very heavy, do you ever wonder why it takes more force and it's harder to lift? Why is it that when you hit something very hard, it hurts your hand in the process? Well, I am here to teach you the three laws of motion from Newton. Newton's first law states that an object at rest will remain at rest, and an object in motion will remain in motion at a constant speed and in a straight line unless acted on by an unbalanced force. Newton's first law has two parts. The first part is the part where an object is at rest unless acted on by an unbalanced force. The second part would be the part where an object in motion will always stay in motion unless acted on by an unbalanced force. An example of the first part of Newton's first law is when an object at rest is pushed and moved by an unbalanced force. Here we see a toy car which is at rest. And if I were to exert a pushing force on it, it will be moved, like so. When it is being pushed, it is no longer at rest. An example of the second part of Newton's first law is when an object in motion is stopped by an unbalanced force. When this car is in motion, it is quickly stopped because of the friction on the tires and in the axles of the car. Newton's first law is also called the law of inertia. Inertia is the way objects would resist being moved. An object with a smaller mass has less inertia and will be easier to move. An object with a larger mass will have more inertia and will be harder to move. Newton's second law states that the acceleration of an object depends on the object's mass and the amount of force applied. An example of Newton's second law is the force needed to push this textbook to a certain speed. This textbook needs this much force to move at this speed. But if another textbook were added on top of it, it would need a lot more force to move at the same speed. Newton's third law states that whenever one object exerts a force on the second object will always exert the equal and opposite force on the first. This basically means that all forces act in pairs. An example of Newton's third law is when a ball is thrown at a wall. When this ball is thrown, it exerts a force onto the wall, but the wall will exert an equal and opposite force onto the ball, and that's what makes the ball bounce back. Just like this. Like that. Those were Newton's theorems. Thank you for watching.